Oh my God. Oh my head.
Dad? Just answer me that! Your whole family. Your whole blood. What the hell were you thinking? What in the hell crossed your mind? The fuck is happening to you? You've ruined our family. What am I gonna do now? What am I gonna do?
Dad, please. Please talk to me. I don't understand what's going on. Dad, stop. You're not making any sense.
You are not my son! You are not my son! The priest was right. What an idiot that was.
Maybe I can get up through Grandpa's house. I gotta get out of here. I won't be able to go back. I need to find a way out before Dad notices I'm here. Wasn't there a door here? Is just like Dad. My birthday present? How did it get here? should find a nail or something to hang it with. What the hell has Dad been doing here?
priest Thomas? Notebook? So Dad's the one who took it away from me. I don't remember drawing any of these. Am I going insane? Dad said he was repairing Grandpa's house. But instead, he's been investigating this woman? What is going on? No signal. Fuck. This storm must have taken out the power. I think Grandpa had a generator in the basement. Grandma and Grandpa's room. Smells awful. The pipes must be clogged. Blue knees? Grandpa dedicated his whole life to clockmaking.
Thank you. From the moment of first contact, it is already too late. When a demon attaches itself to a human...
Demons?
It becomes a parasite of sorts. It feeds from the host until it devours every last part of their soul. In most instances, the demon's relentless objective is to get back to the world of the living. If you want to break that link, well, I'm afraid it's no simple matter. I could speak at length about various rituals and procedures, but by far the best way is to obey. Help the demon attain that which it seeks. Only then will the demon leave of its own accord. Usually they enter the earthly plane through certain objects that they use as conduits between worlds. Even if you rid yourself of that object later, the demon has made the contact it needs and already walks among us. In the first stages of possession, the host human tends to withdraw from friends and family, becoming aggressive, even violent. This is the result of the spiritual battle between the host and the entity, both vying for control over the mortal body. The symptoms that indicate that the possession is progressing are dizziness, nausea, and headaches, the latter of which can be so intense as to render the host unconscious for days. The dark entity manipulates its host with visual hallucinations and voices in the mind. Destroying the sanity of the host is for the purpose of making them malleable, compliant. This is how the demon fully exerts its insidious control. Oh, and before I forget, several cases of possession saw strange behavioral patterns in nearby insects, cockroaches in particular. My advice, steer clear of the insects.
There's just no way. I can't be possessed. There must be a mistake. Those pictures, that leg, that arm, I didn't do it. Dad thinks it was me, but God. My head. A door. A red door. What's happening to me? Is this what that man was talking about? It can't be happening to me. Could it be the basement door? What is this place? This is impossible. What's wrong with me? Those symbols. I've seen them before. It looks like a crime scene. Chains? Maybe I can break them with something. I should keep this. Be able to open it easily. second ago. Officer Russell?
Officer Russell here. June 17th, 1987, 5:27 a.m. I am now entering Madison Hill's basement.
Madison Hill? 1987?
I can see there's a sort of well in the center of the room. Looks like it's open. I'm gonna investigate further, see what's on the other side of this. Madison? Is that you? Police! Show yourself! That's an order!
Why is this happening to me? I gotta get the hell out of... Is it possible that she's still alive?